It is the 17th day of March 2020. Thank you for watching New Vision TV. I am Ruthina Sijie. Here we look at stories making news across the country. We started from Gulu District, where bean prices have skyrocketed. Now traders dealing in beans are worried and frustrated as wholesale prices reach 4,500 per kilogram, which is an increase of over 1,000 in the last 3 months.
This year there is no business. Somebody come like expecting that we'll go with 100 kilos and goes with 70 kilos. It frustrates those one who sell retailers. And you find from the village where they're selling, the same challenge they're also facing. They're saying it takes long, customers are complaining, the sales are not moving as fast as it was expected.
Now, Vicky Emutai, the General Secretary of the Gulu City Vendors Association, explains that traders in Gulu buy beans from as far as Kampala, Masaka and Rwanda.
We have suppliers that when you call the number of times you want, you put the money in the bank, then they bring for you worth your money. We go and buy beans from there because that is fresh. Ours, we always get up to July. Those one who has big stores, I think they access from Rwanda. We have their numbers that we connect and we call and put for me this number of tons. So that's how we are processing at the moment.
In the last few months, the wholesale prices per kilogram for each type of beans, such as yellow beans, is at 4,500. Masamvu and Army Green are at 4,000. And there has been a rise of over 1,000 shillings. Now, Francis Achire believes the prices from the suppliers in Kampala and Rwanda should be regulated so they can also make a profit. Crossing over to Kanungu District, a suspected coronavirus patient in Kanungu has tested negative. A tour guide, whose name is still withheld, was put in isolation unit on Wednesday last week with symptoms of coronavirus. Now, according to a tweet posted by the Minister of Health on Monday, the blood samples taken from the patient have tested negative, but the patient remains in isolation for 14 days and supervision of medical officers. Yes, you're watching New Vision TV News around Uganda with me, Ruth Inaseje. We take a break as we look at what is making news in today's copy of the New Vision. Now, for those who want to access the hard copy of the New Vision, the link is on your screen. All you have to do is to subscribe to our e-paper and access all the products published by Vision Group. We continue looking at more stories making news across the country. From Kampala, Uganda's capital city, police have charged events promoter Andrew Mukasa, aka Bajo, with common nuisance. Bajo was Monday arrested at Uganda Road Court, where he had come with a mattress, flask and a mosquito net, protesting against delay by court refund his bail fees. Bajo had vowed to sleep at the court premises until he is refunded, as court ruled while dismissing his case, in which he was charged with inciting violence against the president in a video posted on social media. The Kampala Metropolitan Police Deputy Spokesperson Luke Oyesigire says the suspect has been charged with common nuisance and investigations are going on. We close off from the capital, Kampala, where Supreme Court has set aside 1 month during which it will hear and determine 64 civil appeals and applications from April the 7th to May the 7th. The cases include one where Kampala non-practicing lawyer Malema Bidiza seeks to overturn a judgment in which the Court of Appeal dismissed a land case he filed against the Kabaka of Buganda, Ronald Mwenda Mutebi. That is all I had for you this morning. Thank you for watching. Be sure to catch more news updates and other programs here on New Vision TV by visiting our website, which is newvision.co.ug/video.